Tonight, the first video of a hostage held inside Gaza, released by Hamas. In it, 21-year-old Maya Shem asks to be brought home as soon as possible and says she's being given medical care. It's unclear if she's being forced to make the statement.
Shem was one of the Israelis who was kidnapped at the Nova Festival near the Gaza Strip after Hamas fighters launched a terror attack on October 7th that so far killed at least 1,400 Israelis. Now here's more on Shem and the video released by Hamas.
For the first time, video of one of the 199 hostages taken into Gaza. Hamas, the militant group behind the brazen attack on October 7th, releasing video of 21-year-old French-Israeli citizen Mia Shem. Her family giving us permission to show these images. She was kidnapped with many others from the music festival. I just ask that you'll bring me home as soon as possible to my family, she says, to my parents, to my brothers. Please get us out of here as soon as possible. Overnight, her family speaking out.
I saw my baby on television. I saw she's alive. I didn't know if she's dead or alive until yesterday. All I knew is that she's might be kidnapped. I'm begging the world to bring my baby back home.
Now that was her mother, Karen. She said that she had heard all sorts of rumors about what had happened to her daughter ahead of time. She's told CNN, quote, I heard before rumors that she was shot in the shoulder or in the leg, so I can see she was shot in her shoulder. I see she had an operation. She looks very terrified. She looks like she is in big pain, and I can see that she says what they tell her to say. Now, there are serious concerns about the hostages who are held captive in the Gaza Strip. There are estimated to be anywhere between 199, and now new reports indicate that there are as many as 250 Israeli hostages. Well, hostages, not all of them are Israeli. Some of them are actually foreign hostages who happen to be in Israel at the time of this attack. But there are some serious concerns that Israel might not be prioritizing the hostages at the moment, considering the humanitarian blockade, from any water entering the area, which obviously not only impacts the Palestinian civilians, but it impacts the hostages who are in the Gaza Strip at the moment. And there was an interesting comment made by an expert who has been tasked with negotiating hostage situations. He had a perspective here that I think is worth sharing with you all. So let's take a look.
To start a dialogue with Hamas, we have to understand who can do it. And the ones who can do it are the countries that have influence over Hamas, which are Qatar, Turkey, and Egypt, and Iran.
Baskin says there's a small window of opportunity to make a deal to release hostages.
It's a matter of days, probably a week, before the Israeli ground forces go into Gaza. That's when the window for negotiation closes.
But that means that hostages are sacrificed.
It means that hostages are going to be tried to be freed. And they might be sacrificed. My sense of the pulse of the Israeli public right now, the government and the military, is that the primary objective today is to remove Hamas from its ability to govern. And that means that hostages may be sacrificed. This hurts me so much to say that the hostages might be considered additional casualties of the war for Israel's survival.
Obviously, that's devastating. And keep in mind that many of those hostages are in need of medical attention. That's according to officials who have more information about who these individual hostages are, including a 9-month-old baby who clearly doesn't have access to formula, and other individuals, elderly people who are suffering from kidney disease and need dialysis. It's just absolutely devastating. Yeah.
The governments of the world take advantage sometimes of media's inability to state something clearly. So we talked about that earlier in the hour in regards to the hospital bombing in Gaza. But there was an excellent example of it from the first clip that we showed you from Lester Holt. If you notice at the end, he said about the hostage video, quote, unclear if she's being forced to make that statement. No, Lester, it's perfectly clear. Of course she's being forced to make that statement. She's a hostage of Hamas. There is, like, you don't have to bother saying there's a 0.00001% chance that maybe she voluntarily made a video. She's like, oh, Hamas, can I make a video? And she wanted to make a video, and and the fact that she's a hostage didn't play a role. It's absurd. Yes, of course she was forced to make it. So just please, just you can state things clearly from time to time. All right. So now back to the main issue. Look, there's this what I view to be an insane line of thinking that unfortunately, apparently the Israeli government thinks is possible, and I've seen people saying it as if it's possible. We're going to keep hitting Gaza until we eliminate Hamas's ability to govern. What does that mean? What do you think, they're just gonna give up? Like they have we all call them a terrorist group. After they won that one election, they didn't allow any more elections and then ruled in a dictatorial way. I mean, that's the nature of not having elections. So you think that those guys, the guys who just did the barbaric attack on Israel, are gonna turn around and go, oh, you're right, we can't govern anymore. We'll let someone else do it. Do you think that there's gonna be a random uprising of moderate Palestinians that are somehow going to get enough military goods from who to fight back against Hamas in the streets and then govern the Palestinians? Has anybody thought about this for one second? There's no chance that's gonna happen. That's an absurd thing to say. The only reason you'd say that is just to say, well, I don't want an end date on this. I don't want a real objective. I just want to punish them. Collective punishment, hell yeah. And we're gonna teach them a lesson. All they understand is violence. That's the real objective. And the fact that you can't just take that one guess opinion for it, but there is a legitimate school of thought that he represents that says that apparently some in the Israeli government are saying, forget the hostages, let's just punish them, punish the Palestinians so they don't do it again. The idea that that a real military objective is that Hamas cannot govern anymore is not a thing. It's just made up. It has no logical connection to reality, and there is no pathway to get there, and no one can define when we'll get there. Wait, okay, go ahead, Netanyahu's government, tell me, when can you determine that Hamas no longer has the ability to govern? That's such an absurdly vague statement anyway, it's not even provable. So this is just vengeance, and I get the desire for vengeance, but that's not what governments should do, and that's not what governments we support should do, especially against civilians, and mainly against civilians, and that's what's happening here.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.